Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in a hadith, it's called the science of ulum al-hadith muttafaqun alayh, completely agreed upon, like a consensus by al-Bukhari and Muslim and all other narrators. سئل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أي الإسلام أفضل؟ قال من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. Now literally the translation could be as such, saying, يا رسول الله, which Islam is the best? The meaning which Islam is the best is, which is the best thing in Islam to be done? In case if I'm a Muslim and I have a limitation of time, and I have tens of beautiful wanted things, and I have a limited time to do the best thing, what is the best thing to do in Islam, Ya Rasulullah? قال من سلم المسلمون من لسانه ويده. It's the person whom the Muslims around him has been saved from his tongue and his hand. Look how brief it was. من سلم المسلمون. Muslims would be saved. They are in peace, fully saved from his tongue and his hand. Now the tongue includes many things such as backbiting, lying, hatred, you know, envy, all of that, which destroys a lot of things. So it's not an easy thing. And you know, in Islam, and a very famous other hadith, hadith of Mu'adh radiallahu anhu, كان مع رسول الله, he was with Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, listening to something, then Mu'adh said, يا رسول الله, أو نحن مؤاخذون بما نتكلم به, يا رسول الله, are we accountable for what we say? You know, we are just uttering, you know, just blah 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 blah, it just talks. This is what Mu'adh thought. It's just, you know, just I'm talking. So, am I accountable for it? نحن مؤاخذون بما نتكلم به. قال ثكلتك أمك يا معاذ. وهل يكب الناس في النار على مناخرهم أو قال على وجوههم إلا حصائد ألسنتهم. The classical translation for ثكلتك أمك, it's well unto thee, or wow to you. In our simple language, it says, what are you saying? طبعا, definitely, you are accountable. قال ثكلتك أمك يا معاذ. Do you think that there is anything other than the harvest and the fruit of your tongue, the fruit of the tongue, that will throw the people in the hellfire on the day of judgment more than what comes out of their tongues? Which means what comes from here is classified as a top priority dangerous elements that we are accountable for. So you have to count to 10, I have to count to 100 before I say something. Am I hurting? Am I saying the truth? Am I destroying? Am I dividing the people? Am I, you know, conveying something? Am I uncovering the privacy of some people? You know, tens of problems. So this is the first. Now, the next part, سَلَمُ مُسْلِمُ مِنْ لِسَانِهِ وَيَدِهِ, his hand. Now, literally, the hand, this is the hand, which means the physical power. This is the literal meaning, which is the bottom line of the meaning. Muslims should be saved from my physical power. If I'm so powerful, I'm not supposed to, you know, like bullying at school, like, you know, if I'm so powerful, which is the basic. Now, the word hand is used as well for any kind of power, any kind of authority. I can, by my authority, my power, in Arabic language, we say فلان إيدو طايلق, أو إيدو طويلق, أو إيدو واصلق. We say he has a very long hand, metaphorically speaking, majaz, which means he can do a lot of things just by a telephone. Ah, marhaba sa'adtak, marhaba atuftak, your excellency, bidiflam trabbu. Okay, hadar. Immediately he's in jail. Okay? This is power, authority. This is one of the power. Qal man salima al-muslimuna. I have a problem with you. For whatever reason. I hate you, you hate me. Okay. I have a tribe behind me. Have relatives. I can talk with them. They will make your life hell. You don't deserve it. Okay, I hate you. You hate me. But what I'm doing now, I'm transgressing etidailla. Okay, I'm using the power of my against you. This is completely haram. So the conclusion, since in Ramadan, alhamdulillah, we have more numbers in listening. This is good opportunity to know better about our Islam. Because at the end, respected brothers and sisters, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said clearly to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَّةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا. We have not sent you but to every single person on earth. So we are the representatives of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we are messengers for everyone else. And subhanAllah, by the will of Allah, the fact that we are living in a non-Muslim country, this duty will be much more important. If the majority around you are Muslims, maybe you will say, okay, but now you can't. We are minority here in terms of majority are non-Muslims. So they must see part of the true Islam, or otherwise we are accountable. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yarhamu wa rahmatuh, taqabbal ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum.